Hi everyone. So today I've come with a very short and quick topic that what is the actual order in which the milk teeth erupt? And the reason why I chose this topic is because in my clinical practice I see a lot of patients getting worried about why did this tooth erupt? You're supposed to have our lower front teeth erupting first, and I have my child with his upper front teeth erupting first. Is there a problem, or why did this tooth erupt? So there's nothing to worry about. You just need to relax, because there's a pattern, of course, but it's not necessary that all the children follow that same pattern. Now, in most of the cases, let's say almost 70 to 80% of the cases, the first tooth to erupt usually are the lower front teeth. So the picture, can you see? This is the most common visual to be seen when the children have their lower front teeth erupting in their mouth. But as I said before, there can be a time when instead of your lower front teeth, the child has the upper front teeth erupting. So there's absolutely nothing to worry about. This is a very common and a very normal variation in the order of eruption of teeth. Now, the second tooth to erupt are usually the lateral incisors. That means the both of those teeth that are present beside those central large teeth. Those are called as lateral incisors. And the lateral incisors, most commonly the upper lateral incisors, are to erupt before the lower lateral incisors. But if you have your lower lateral incisors erupting before the upper lateral incisors, then again, that's also not a problem. Either of these situations are normal, and either of them can come before each other. Now, the third set of teeth that are to erupt are the first molar. That means the primary first molar. Now, in this case also, the upper first molars are usually early to erupt than the lower first molars. There's a general pattern basically that in primary teeth or the milk teeth, the upper set of teeth are usually erupting before the lower set of teeth. And after the first molars, we have the canines. Yes, those sharp teeth that you can see with a pointed edge, that's called as the canine. So after the first molar, it's the canine. And again, the upper canines erupt earlier than the lower canines on general basis, but otherwise also is a normal variation. And the last set of teeth to erupt are the second molars. And in the case of second molars, the lower second molars usually erupt before the upper second molar. But again, either of this is a normal variation. There's nothing to worry if the upper second molar comes before the lower second molar. So yes, we can just revise what we just got to know, and this will help. I've basically denoted all the eruption sequences with numbering, as you can see in this figure. That is, the first to erupt are the central incisors, the upper central incisors, that means your upper front teeth, then the lower front teeth, then the lower side teeth or the lateral incisors, or sometimes the upper side teeth. Basically, then you have your first molars, then you have your canines, then you have your second molars. So usually the upper might come, or sometimes the lower might come. 50 to 60% cases, the upper comes before the lower, but rest of the cases, even if the lower teeth come before the upper teeth, there's absolutely nothing to worry. Why I am stressing on this is because I get so many queries from parents, and they are just concerned about this, that the lower had to erupt, the upper has erupted, will the lower erupt, or the lower has erupted, the upper had to erupt, why did upper not erupt? So that is why I'm stressing again and again, there's no problem. That's it. I tried to wind up the order of eruption of primary teeth as much as possible. But if there's something you were not able to understand or you have query related to, please let me know in the comment section. Till then, happy teaching. Take care.